Hello everyone, today we will be discussing about the lab program 5. Lab program 5 is just that is merge sort. We have already discussed merge sort in the lecture videos. Sort a given set of n integer elements using merge sort method and compute its time complexity. Run the program for varied values of n greater than 5000 and record the time taken to sort. So we are using the merge function here. The class name is merge sort and merge function here. And I am setting the value I, j and k. I is equal to low, j is equal to mid plus 1 and k is equal to low. And result array also I am declaring it here with the size, that is max. Max is declared as 10,000. Now while I less than or equal to mid and then j less than or equal to high, what we are doing is we are checking the values array of I and array of j. If it is array of I is less, result array we are putting array of I, and I and k we are incrementing. K is the index value for the result array. Otherwise array j will be bigger and it will be otherwise array j will be the lesser, it will be copied to the result array and j and k will be incrementing here. And suppose after comparison if some other elements are left out in the both the parts, what we will do is that values also we will copy into the result array. That's why you have given here while I less than or equal to mid and j less than or equal to high, copy all those values there. Then all these values result array again we are copying back to array M so that we will get the result in the same array. Now for sorting, in order to sort, now we have to divide this one into two parts. So based on the mid value only we will be dividing into two parts. So sort as a recursive function, and first we will be finding out the mid value. Mid is equal to low plus high by 2, and next the same sort algorithm will be applied for the left part of mid and the right part of the mid. So from low to mid we will call the array sort function again, and from mid plus 1 to high again we are calling the sort array. After that we are calling the merge function to merge it. So these two things will do the division part, and the remaining part will do the merge. So this is the divide and this is the merge part. Now in the main function we'll be reading the value of n from the user. For that you are creating an object for the scanner class. After declaring this one we are calling it random generator function, because here the number generated will be randomly. So n numbers we have to generate, n generator, by using generator we are calling the nextInt function. After that we are printing the array before sorting, because we should know which are the elements that is generated randomly by the computer. Then we should know the time also to execute. For that you are calling the start time here, that is system.nanotime. So it will take the system time in start time. Then we will be calling the merge sort function. After that again we are calling the stop time, because we will come to know which time it has ended. Then elapsed time we are printing, start is stop time minus start time, it will be printed here. Time taken to sort array is elapsed time. And at the end we are printing the sorted array. The sorted array will be array of I. So this is the same logic, almost same logic like quicksort algorithm, but little difference in dividing the array, because here we are not using the partition algorithm, here we are using the sort algorithm to divide elements into the different parts. Now we will check the demonstration for this. For this in the quicksort, see I have already created the class here called the merge sort. So this is a merge sort function, the same program code is copied here, and this one I am going to run it. Into the array size, it is asking the array size. So what I am giving here is the array size I am giving has 10. Now when I press enter, array before sorting is 3. This is the random number which is generated by the computer by using the random function that we have used in the program. And time taken to sort array is this many nanoseconds, because it will be taking the system time before sorting and after sorting. And the sorted array is this. This is the sorted array we got. So this is the way you have to do this one. Only we have to give the array size here. Remaining everything is generated directly by the computer. Hope you understood this one. So this is the merge sort algorithm. So try to do this one in your system so that you will be able to get the identify the errors which is detected in the program, and you have to correct the errors. Then execute it. So don't copy paste, because when you type the program only you will be able to identify the mistakes. That's all for today. Thank you.